Well, there we go. Welcome everybody here to NES fans. My name's slapartist, and tonight we're going to be streaming DuckTales. Let me go ahead and turn some of the music down there. I like the DuckTales music. Sounds pretty good. Today we're doing a couple things different. For one, I'm going to be actually be using cheat codes on this game because I kind of want to get through it fairly quick tonight. So I'm actually running cheat codes on this for infinite lives. And now I could change it for something else, and I might do that. You know, I might switch it to infinite life as well. But we'll go ahead and do it with lives first and see how that goes. But I just want to let you guys know that there we go, that I am using it with that. So using cheat codes on it just to help me get through it there. I don't want to be a struggle bus for it tonight, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. Anyway, let's see here and see what I got. Sorry, I got a couple messages coming through and just making sure I'm taking care of business there. All right. Sorry about that. I got a few things happening here. All right. Anyway, back to it. So again, we're going to be doing DuckTales, and I'm really excited for it here. And this weekend, don't forget that what we have coming up here is the Chrono Trigger weekend. Here we're going to be doing an entire viewing of Chrono Trigger from beginning to end on Friday morning, like starting at 10 a.m. I think I put 9:30, but we're going to starting at 10 a.m. Mountain Time. We're going to be doing it from beginning to end. Like I said, no Rainbow Sword. I'm bringing a guest friend in who's a fantastic Chrono Trigger player, and it's probably his favorite game in the entire world. So what better opportunity than to bring him on and run this? So let's go ahead and just get started on DuckTales and see how well this goes. All right, let me turn some game audio up here. And we'll get started here. Yes, thank you, Schmitty. I do appreciate it. Yeah, Chrono Trigger is a fantastic game. So that's happening this Friday. So here, I'm going to go ahead and send you a link to it. Let me send this to you. I'll post it, and that's what I'll do. Let me copy this, paste it in here for you so you have a link to it. There you go. And we're going to be doing this on Twitch, and I might do it through Restream just for the fact because then I can. So I was looking for something. If I do it on Restream, I can also do it on Facebook as well. But I think I'm just going to go ahead and, you know, just stick with it on Twitch just because it looks so much better. But we're doing free game, we're doing some game giveaways during the Chrono Trigger playthrough, and it's happening. It's going to be an all day Friday thing, and it's going to be an all day Saturday thing too. We'll be playing for multiple hours, you know, maybe 10 hours, you know, and we hope to get through it in about 20 to 25 hours. Probably happen a little faster with my buddy who's going to be doing it. He's going to be sitting here alongside me, and we're going to hammer that game out. And I'm going to be playing. He's going to be playing. It should be good. But let's go ahead and get started on DuckTales. But I do appreciate you sticking around here. Let's do it on normal, like I said. test stream here again to build up for the real one, which is the Chrono Trigger coming up this weekend. Schmitty, was that you? Was it you I remember that was the Super Metroid fan that was making sure to have me double check stuff? Oh yeah, look at these infinite hit points. Hell yeah. Let's just roll through this game now, no problem. Look at this. Bam, bam. Look at this, I'm actually doing better with infinite hit points than I would be trying to avoid everything. Oh, that would just follow that B. Feel like if you're following something like that, you're not gonna have to deal with, you know, flying. It's kind of like the Ninja Gaiden effect too. If you're following something, there's gonna be less of a critter or something to hit you. No, not you. Sorry, Schmitty. I can't remember. I had a few streamers that were watching with me. A is yes. B is no. I just... Oh. Okay. Well, guess I gotta do that again. Let's just roll through it. So, Schmitty, you're gonna be around to be able to see some of the Chrono Trigger stream that's happening this weekend? Please, again, share the link with some people. I'm trying to get as many people in there as possible to watch it. You know, I mean, I understand that RPGs aren't going to be the best thing to be streamed. You know, it's no Fortnite or anything where it's a lot of shit, where it's a lot of action. But again, it's Chrono Trigger, man. Yeah, Schmitty, I was doing it on Facebook. I was playing Rescue Rangers. I actually played Rescue Rangers 1, and then I decided to go ahead and do Rescue Rangers 2 in the same evening. And both played on I have carts for both of them. Both played on the Analogue NT Mini. And if you know anything about retro video games, Rescue Rangers 2 is... It's an expensive game. You know, it's no Little Samson or Panic Restaurant or Kid... Yeah, it's up there, probably Kid Clown. But I ended up winning it off a lottery. Kind of a... You know, you put so much money in for a spot. It's like 10 bucks for a spot. I think I bought like... I don't know, 6-7 spots and ended up winning it. And it's all kind of for a good cause. But ended up taking that down and Mighty Final Fight too. Which I was pissed because I wanted Snow Bros. Yeah, I hope you do come in and give it a watch. It's a fantastic RPG. I love Chrono Trigger. I don't play it as much as I probably should. I mean, it's hard to get into RPGs these days. And again, this is nice not to have worry about hit points. Look at this. So you own it? Sure, I wish I had the money for this. Actually, what is it? You can actually pass this? Ooh, we're gonna get this. Watch this. There we go. I do beat him many years ago. What's your favorite SNES game, or do you have a favorite game? Schmitty, go ahead and let me know. Mine's Super Metroid, hands down. Favorite game even of all time. Yeah, Chrono Trigger is amazing. Earthbound. You know, I hate to say it, but I never played Earthbound as a kid. Sorry, give me one second here. I'm looking for something really quick. Sorry about that. I do apologize. I couldn't find my chapstick. Believe that or not. Earthbound, good game, expensive. Yeah, I do have the original. I never played it as a kid. Ended up getting it off, believe it or not, I got it off GameStop's website. And I know there's a lot of hullabaloo about people selling bad copies and reproductions to GameStop. Although that's very true, they're doing that. Got it off GameStop's website as a pro member, and I got a discount on it. I think I got it for about $140, $130. Screaming good deal. And it turned out to be legitimate. I mean, the sticker, let's see here. Save him. The sticker's in actually pretty good shape, but it's one I never played. Never played it. Bunch of good reviews about it, you know. I mean, I still have the Nintendo Power issue with it when the stickers, they had the scratch and stiff Snickers. Oh, they smelled terrible. Oh, you like my green canteen see-through. Find it. Is it here? There it is. There's your first extra hit point. My grandma bought it at clearance when I was a kid, played it through twice, came with the strategy. Oh, so you have the strategy guide with it. I mean, I would love to own the strategy guide. I got a massive collection of strategy guides, and it's just something I've always liked as a collector, are good strategy guides. And that's one I would love to own, and I just don't own it. It's expensive, you know, it's expensive for the strategy guide, and though I'd love to have it, I mean, is it worth it? So good for you, man. That's awesome your grandma bought that. I'm actually a little jealous. So if you ever want to get rid of that strategy guide, let me know. Is it in good shape? Did you get the game in good shape and stuff? I don't know where I'm going in this game, by the way. Thank you. jealous that you were able to get one of those. He's already here. I'm jealous you're able to get the strategy guide with it too, and you probably got it dirt cheap at the garage sale. See here, not something you'd ever sell. Yeah, don't sell it. I mean, I'd love to own it. I mean, obviously I'm gonna be paying for it, but keep it. Go to the right under the mirror up top. That was there. All right, so now I'm just making these giant loops. False wall under the mirror that you just teleported through. Alright, I'll get back there. Have you played this game a lot? I haven't played it in years, and I remember beating it as a child. And this is a game that would cause me a ton of anxiety. I mean, games like this are tough. I mean, you saw Rescue Rangers is tough. Very nice, thank you. What one do I go and do here? Just a few times he's beaten it. I own part two. I own DuckTales part two, and I got it. Tell me what mirror to go in here. I had a friend that through some complications he went a little crazy and left a huge box of Nintendo games, SNES games, Sega games, a bunch of everything in this giant box in my friend's car after he kind of took my friend's car, and he got the car back, and then it came with all those video games, and ended up buying the box of video games for $80, and included in that was Zombie Nation, DuckTales 2. I was hoping I'd get Bubble Bobble 2, but at the time, this was years ago, and these games weren't worth as much. I got Zombie Nation out of that. What mirror do I go into? I bought the afternoon collection for my PS4. Yeah, the PS4 collection's fun. The right one, honestly, I don't remember. Sure, let's do it. We're gonna find out. Is the right one the right one? Looks right to me. I got the ghost to deal with. Should try to avoid him instead of running through it. Oh man, look at this. Didn't she? There it is. That's when I gotta get her. I'm gonna get her here too. Kind of looks like the lightning bolts from Bubble Bobble, right? Which is a great game. And Bubble Bobble 2, it's grossly overpriced. And I don't think it's as good as the first one. I think some people will beg to differ. I don't know. There's this giant obsession to own expensive games. And I bought a few just because I know the titles are good. I did pick up Snow Bros a while ago. And I got it for actually a really good deal, but the damnedest thing is the gentleman who sent it to me gave it to his fiance or wife, and she just put it in a bubble mailer. Not even that. She put it in just like an envelope, like a plastic envelope, sent it to me, and something happened to where it got punctured with something sharp, went right through the plastic, right into the board, and bent the chips in the board. And when I got it, I was sick. For the simple fact, I got a pretty good deal for it. I think I spent... Oh, can I not go here? It's in Transylvania. How do I call? I need a key. It's in Transylvania. Alright, so I guess I'm here, so I gotta find a key. But ended up, getting the game. Had to send it back. I was sick over it. Casino Kid for $60. There you go. Nice. I think I own Casino Kid. Maybe, I don't know, I'm not too sure. I picked up Cowboy Kid for about $130 is what I bought it for. Now that game is about $130. That game is kind of grossly expensive. I think it's over the top. I need a key here. Should be back at the first mirror. Do I have to stand in front of the mirror for a while? Whoa. See that nonsense? Okay, I guess I never checked that. Nicely done. You should be streaming this game instead of me. Alright. Just walk right through it. I wanted Snow Bros. You know, and it's a fun game. But again, it's a game that I think's a little too expensive. I had a chance to buy Little Samson, I think, for about $400 or $500, but at the time, I was, you know, that's a lot of money. I missed that. But a lot of these games, Schmitty, I bought a years ago, maybe about 3 or 4 years ago, I bought a Raspberry Pi and then modded it up, you know, and put an emulator in it and stuff. And the buddy, the guy that's going to be streaming Chrono Trigger with me is the one that introduced it to me. And I figured that was there. And so I ended up doing the whole Raspberry Pi thing. And that's great, too. Ooh, there we go. Look at this. What's in here? Right, liking it. Just to emulate it, it's worth, yeah, $1,200-$1,300 now. And looking at it, I probably should have just bucked up and paid for it. I honestly wouldn't pay... I wouldn't pay $1,200 for it. I mean, that's getting to a new level of collecting. And I have some sealed Nintendo games that are graded and sealed. And my most expensive one is probably original copy of Final Fantasy. I think they got an 80 on it for the grading, all sealed in a UV case and everything. That, I have that one, and those are my most expensive. And I just emulate. If I need to emulate Little Samson, I'll do it. But that's probably my most expensive game is the Final Fantasy, the sealed one. And that's probably worth $400 or $500. And I have that one, Blaster Master, Star Tropics. I got an NES, I got the GameCube Collector's Edition that has all the Zeldas on it. I got it as a promotional item. I have Shadowgate, which is sealed and which is great. I love Shadowgate. And I think that might be it. I think I have Star Tropics 2 as well. But I mean that's a cool hobby to get into, is to collecting the sealed ones, but expensive. Too expensive. Yeah, Shadowgate's great. I love it. I played it not too long on NES fans. I'm assuming that's where you've seen some of me streaming some of these games, but I did a Shadowgate stream. It did fairly well. I did Star Tropics a while back. I mean, that was a while back. I got all the way to the end, and I was able to do it in... I thought I jumped out. I was able to... do Star Tropics in 2 days, but I got to the very end and I was just so tired that I couldn't beat the boss. And I just couldn't beat him, so I had to put infinite life on to beat him. I just couldn't get it done. But Star Tropics is one of my favorite games, Nintendo games ever made. And it just... What the hell am I doing wrong? Wow, 60 games short of owning every NES game. If you can get a photo of it, send it over. I'll post it on NES Fans. I'm an admin over there, along with a few of us. But if you got a copy of it, or a photo of all his games, if he has them displayed, send it over, and we'll get it posted. That's pretty amazing. You know, and I'm sure he's missing some of the heavy hitters. I'm assuming that's what it is. Look at that, I can jump right out of there. I'll just let them die. Yeah, right, gotta jump out. These are long levels. Think it, when playing this as a kid, you know, there's just things that you have to remember to do and know where guys are all the time to do well in a game like this. You know, right now I'm not playing as hard as I could, plus I have infinite lives and infinite health, but games like this are very difficult. I'm a base guy. They're very difficult. I would think that'd really be cool. Sorry, I'm messing with my cut here. My size of my screen. There we go. Oh, wait. That, I need that side. That's not the side. 500. But if I keep cutting this one. There we go. Alright, moving on. Oh, that's right, I can't jump down in the snow here with my cane. Oh, the moon level. Oh, man. I remember that. Music, I think the music was fun for the moon level, if I remember right. It's a Billy Goat. So glad I have infinite health on this. Actually, on NES fans, there's a stream of it. I think it's on NES fans when I did it. I didn't die once, and I was able to beat it in an hour. Not like this game. Don't I need, thought I needed, a receiver or somebody to call, like, Duckburg or something to have him blow up a wall or something. Gosh, I have no idea where to go with this. Yeah, Rygar's great. I love it. I probably have to stream it again. Because when I first streamed it, I did it on, Retro Gaming Fans, one of our other pages, instead of NES Fans, because I wasn't streaming back then. But yeah, Rygar's great, man. Gizmo. That's right. It's Gizmo. So he's saying I have to go up into the spaceship. See how far I can go. Down on the first floor to the left. Okay, well, that's where we're heading then. Yeah, this level would be somewhat of a nightmare. Is that the first level? Yeah. A nightmare without some cheat codes. But for sake of time, again. Back up under Webby. Okay. Yeah, you obviously know this game a heck of a lot better than I do. I don't know if this was the floor or the next one. There we go. Nope, I don't want to talk to you. Look at this guy. I'm just gonna go right by him. Is there a secret here? Well, the best part about it is these retro games is that some people will never understand. No, sorry, the delay is horrible. No, it's fine. I'm streaming it as fast as I can. And what I mean by that is I'm trying to have as little lag as possible. And it still gives me a delay. I mean, that's going to be regardless of it. I mean, that's going to happen. If it's getting too laggy for you, refresh your browser. That might help. There it is. Is Gizmo Duck all the way at the outside of the UFO? Yeah, he is, isn't he? He's outside. You're using the app? Okay. So what's the... What's one of the hardest Nintendo games that you think there is? Ooh, go, go, go. Personally for you. Gizmo Duck. I forgot about Gizmo. Is there something over here? Come on, bounce, 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 bouncy. You know what I was actually impressed with, Schmitty, was with my ability to actually beat Little Nemo again not too long ago on NES Fans. Was able to take that one down, and it was a last life, last boss, and beat him. Nemo could be tough. So where is Dracula Duck? Okay, so you watched the Nemo one. Yeah, I was very lucky on that one. I just remember playing Little Nemo as a kid. That game causing me, I think I cried during it when I was a little kid. It just upset me so much, but I always liked it. I always thought it was a neat thing to be able to overtake the critters. TMT1. Man, there's so many times I hear that. It's one of the hardest games. I don't think I beat... Where am I going the right way? I don't think I beat Ninja Turtles, the first one, much later in life. I think I was in college when I beat it. I think I missed something. Oh, the train's brutal. The train is so tough. And that's the one that actually gave me a ton of difficulty. If you watch me play at the train, I think I spent the most time on the damn train than I did any other level. It just seems too... What am I missing, Schmitty? We'll be right back. TMNT is tough. Another tough game, I think, for me is Battletoads. And we actually have... I'm going the wrong way. I'm all over the place. We actually have a streamer here in the, on the page, Death Adder, who's phenomenal at Battletoads. That's like his game. Secret Wall. Yeah, and I've been through the Secret Wall there. I gotta find Dracula. Yeah, Death Adder's fantastic at Battletoads, and sometimes he'll play it, he'll stream it here, and it's fun to watch him play because he's really damn good at it. And that's just a game I'm not even going to attempt. Faster than you're seeing it, so I apologize for that.